Neil Duff, congratulations. Being Robert Thornton and the smile on your face, you enjoyed that one, didn't you?
I did. Did you know what? I enjoyed playing it. I felt really comfortable up there. There was something about it, I wanted to bite down. I was super focused, even whenever he was just imploding. I went out and done the business. I'm happy to be playing tomorrow.
Did you sense that when he imploded up there that you had him?
That was always in my head. I've known Rob a long time. I've played against him. Once he starts doing the hands flying up there, you know that he's under pressure. He didn't play the way he can play, but I'd like to think that I didn't let him. I went out and bossed him rather than him letting him boss me, and I got the job done. I'm happy that I felt so comfortable up there.
Went in the underdog. I know it's something that you look at. Is that what you liked?
Underdog? A horse doesn't know what price it is. Do you know what I mean? Listen, I made that mistake at the Lakeside. Tournament favourite? Out. Doesn't matter. Richie House only to have 4-1 finishes tomorrow. They got a chance with me. I'm here to the death.
On the Richie House one, obviously that you outplayed him in Yeovil, but he found the big moments when he needed them. Is this revenge tomorrow?
Yeah, I'm not giving it away. I'm not doing Santa Claus tomorrow. Tomorrow, if he wants it, I have to take it off me. I love the fella, lovely guy. It'll be a good game played in the best way it should be, but he'll have to play his A-plus game to beat me tomorrow.
You've seen pretty much everyone play that's in the tournament now, apart from the last one that's on. Is there anyone that can beat you here tomorrow?
Anyone. Anyone can. Well, anyone's got three darts in their hand, they're still in the competition. They can, of course they can. We're taking our Neil Duff, Jim McEwen rematch. That'd be nice.
All right, then.
Listen, one game at a time.
All right, we'll put it another way. Will anyone beat you tomorrow?
No, absolutely not. I came here to win this. I come to win them all, but you know what? I felt against the Richie House match. I let myself down a wee bit that I didn't finish it off when I could have. Fair play to Rich. He took his chances and he put me to bed. But it's only a mistake if you don't learn by it. And I'm not giving away free chances.
Is it nice coming into a TV tournament where you know everything that's going on?
I know what you're doing. Yeah, well, it's always nice to know how much you're paying for and stuff like that. I did listen to the Nick Rolls podcast. So 26th of September is going to be the day where we find out how much we're playing for, when the draw has been made, etc. So I hope it happens. Let's just see.
I'm just going off your words there. I hope it happens. Is there an element of you that thinks it doesn't then?
After the Masters being cancelled, there's always an element there. According to Nick, ticket sales are way surpassed what they were meant about doing. They're hoping to do double than what they've done last year. In my opinion, there's no Masters, so cut it off now. Get the draw done. Let people know when they're playing. Once they know they're playing, then I have a crowd of guys all waiting to come over. I had guys over last year. It was a birthday. This year is one of the other birthdays. They all want to come over. If they know what day I'm playing, there's ticket sales gone. It's not rocket science, and I understand the WDF trying to do the best that they very can. Get the TV deals and stuff in. We'll see what happens.
Looking forward to tomorrow though, now, back here?
Yeah, well, Lee had promised to take me out and buy me a drink tonight, and I don't know where I might have to go home early and keep myself right, in case there's a pool table about, and I have to give him an hour lesson. But we'll see. But I would like to take a questionnaire from dartsnews.com. Oh, they're not here? All right, okay. Oh, that's a shame. That's okay. So you just keep the questions fair and airfield. And whenever they see it tomorrow, they'll spin, put their own spin on it. And I've killed three people and whatever, you know. Yeah, listen, I'm just happy to be here and I'm happy to be contending.
Neil, congratulations.
Cheers, mate.
Well, Neil, a few from Live Darts. We saw you interacting with the crowd up there. How comfortable did you feel on the stage tonight?
That's where I'm feeling the most comfortable, on the stage. I don't shy away from anything. I enjoy it. I enjoy interacting with the crowd. I actually should have done it with the 170, only kind of the dart left my hand before I remembered. The seniors darts crowd are a good crowd. They're darts fans, majority of them. But they're here for darts, and it's money well spent, because they're coming out there and they're getting to see some of the best players there's ever been, some of the luckiest players there ever was, Lakeside singles champions and stuff, you know. So they're getting the money's worth. How this can build and build and build, and I hope people start coming out the doors and buying tickets and come to it.
You've just come through a really tough hurdle, a defending champion. You must really fancy the job now going into tomorrow.
I really fancy myself before I played the Raymond champion. Same way as I did in Circus Tavern, but Robert had a great first stint, 106 average or something like that. But the old saying, the cream comes to the top, and I've got the same buzz now that I had at the Lakeside in April last year, which I haven't had. I've had bits and pieces of it, but I'm playing well. I'm confident in my own darts. I'm confident in the grip. I'm confident in the hold. Anybody wants to stop me, that's they have to play the right game.
You said you've got that same feeling. What's changed then in the last couple of weeks or months to bring that feeling back?
Nothing's really changed. We're just kind of I've started practicing again at home. I'm doing less of the WDF tour. I'm in Modus in 3 weeks' time, so I'm afforded the time at home. So I'm practicing more. I've switched my darts. I'm playing with a set of Simon Whitlock at home. The darts I used tonight, Hendo brought up from Portsmouth and gave to me at 7 o'clock at night. But I'm tinkering and I'm working on my game. I'm working on where I'm falling short. And everything's starting to come together nice.
Do you think there are levels from you that we haven't seen yet?
Well, 1,000,000%. You've seen levels of me at the Lakeside last year when I had to do it, when I was three sets down against McEwen, when I battered Richard Venstra. That's what I can do. But it's consistency makes great players, and I need to get the consistency back. And I feel that's it there. I feel it's there enough for me to win this weekend.
Cheers, Daniel.
Cheers, mate. Okay.